guys. Singapore opened the vaccinated travel lane to 9 destinations in the world. So after almost 3 years without travel, I'm planning to do a trip from Singapore to Paris. But what I read here on the internet seems very complicated, and are a lot of requirements before traveling. So this is vaccinated travel lane, VTL. Of course, it's only for vaccinated people. If you are not vaccinated, you don't have any chance to travel with you in these conditions.
So let's see, I will apply for this program to see if I'm able to travel from Singapore to Paris, France in December before Christmas.
Preparing this travel now in 2021, in December 2021, from Asia to Europe is like preparing for an exam. There are tons of pages and links to read, a lot of information, and many stages and steps to follow. Border COVID measures, pre-departure requirements, before you fly swab test, flight, VTL or test and quarantine requirements, entry restriction section, after arriving requirements, how many swab tests and when you have to perform. According the category of countries you are coming from, first, second, third or fourth, it is accepted IRT, rapid test, or you have to do the PCR. And overall, all are changing almost on a daily basis. When you are thinking that everything is set up and clear, you receive a warning notification and you notice that something has been changed.
I'm going now to make the booster shot, the third Pfizer vaccine, because before traveling, I think it's better to do it, because it's possible in the near future to be considered fully vaccinated if you have it. So better I take it before traveling to be able to have the certificate and not to be any issue. Let's see. So finish, I'm done. The bad thing is that 2 weeks is not allowed to make any sport. Is not allowed to do running, swimming, jogging, gym, nothing for 2 weeks. 2 weeks! Fuck. So the flight tickets, vaccinated travel lane, vaccinated travel pass, travel guard insurance, vaccination certificate, sworn undertaken to comply with the rules of entry. All this. Let's see. Time is really flying away, and I hope that I will fly to France. I'm going now to do the pre-departure swab test.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
minutes.
Oh, yeah. So it's okay.
What time is your flight?
Flight it's at midnight.
Morning. No, but you have to take the PCR test, right?
I take already.
Yesterday.
Yesterday.
Okay.
So I have pre-departure swab test.
Everything done?
Everything done. Vaccination certificate.
Awesome.
Notarize. I think everything should be okay.
Yeah. Your passport?
Yeah. Yeah, the most important.
Yeah.
Happened to anybody to forget the passport? In your experience?
Yes, ever.
Bring me back. Yes. I forgot my passport.
Yeah, bring me back. Yeah. So you need to do a quick swab test in the airport?
I don't know. I have one, but if needed, I will do another one.
Then the test, I believe, have to, because then the result will come. You have to wait for maybe about 15 minutes to see the result in the airport before departure.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
Let's see. I'm here in front of the gate now for departure Singapore to Paris. I arrived a little bit early, but I didn't know how it goes with these restrictions during COVID. So everything went smoothly. When you prepare well, everything is going smoothly. So vaccination certificate and swab test, pre-departure swab test. They check the documents, everything okay. So I'm here ready to fly. Let's see how it goes.